Hello! In this tutorial, we will introduce the major benefits that users get from DataPlay Power Point Add-In and will demonstrate how to create templates. More specifically, you will learn how to create and manage virtual variables, visualize data with charts, filter and generate slides, and group your results. Firstly, you should know that Power Point Add-In has two working modes. One is a template mode, which basically allows to create the analysis structure beforehand and automatically generate or update the presentation once data is available. The other is presentation mode, to directly access and analyze your data from within PowerPoint. Let's examine how DataPlay template functions can help you start analysis early and automate repetitive tasks. Assume that you have a team of researchers working for a multinational automobile manufacturer company, which has long been one of the most successful car makers in the premium segment. However, since autumn 2016, the company recorded a downturn in its total number of vehicles delivered. To determine the cause of customer loyalty decline, you conduct a customer satisfaction survey. Naturally, survey takes a certain amount of time. Meanwhile, with DataPlay, you may create the template before finishing the fieldwork and later generate the presentation whenever the data is ready. Template represents a framework of slides which reflects the analysis structure of your presentation. Thus, all you need is to define your research questions and identify which variables from the questionnaire will help you find answers. Your objective will be to determine the product features contributing to customers' loyalty, and the research question is which product features according to customers need to be improved. Now we will start designing a template. First, let's examine how to create and manage virtual variables. Virtual variables are created in templates in order to connect presentation charts with actual datasets when they are ready. Manage virtual variables from here. You create virtual variables corresponding to your research and survey questions. Let's add some variables from virtual variables window. Willingness to repurchase, willingness to recommend, usage experience, after purchase experience, and some other variables. Now let's see how to visualize data with charts. Once you are done with defining virtual variables, insert some charts with which you would like to visualize your findings. They are available in PowerPoint Add-In toolbar. Afterwards, you need to select the chart and click on crosstab button in order to start assigning virtual variables to charts. Select the titles of each virtual variable you want to assign. Now, filter and generate slides with repeat a variable, which is another virtual variable used in template creation. It is used to filter and generate the slides for each value of the variable selected as a repeater. It's simple to produce hundreds of slides with a deep dive into different groups at once by specifying the repeater variables. For instance, you can regenerate sets of slides for each country in which the company has branches. In order to apply the repeater variable, we should not forget to assign a virtual variable to each specific slide we want to be regenerated from here. Moreover, DataPlay PowerPoint Add-In has a function entitled Special Field, which is a placeholder to be replaced with the actual values from the dataset once the presentation is generated. For instance, you can apply a special field repeater category on the slide, and it will be replaced with the actual values of a selected repeater variable from the dataset during the generation. Similarly, if we select a chart and insert the title as a special field for it, we will have survey questions to be inserted as titles of the charts. Let's assign our dependent variables willingness to repurchase and willingness to recommend a product as repeater variables in order to iterate the generation of these two slides for each of their values. Now, as you are done with the creation of your basic template, you may start grouping your results. You may group the current slide with the previous one if they both have the same repeated categories. Simply click Group with Previous button, and all the analysis structure of the previous and current slides will be firstly generated for the first value of the repeater variable, and after it, the slides will be generated for the next category. This function allows to review your analysis results more properly. To summarize, in this video we examined the main functions of templates and how they accelerate research process. During our next tutorial, we will introduce DataPlay Cloud to see how it enhances team collaboration. Continue exploring our tutorials to know more about DataPlay functionalities. Thank you!